I am right now here at the grotto, at our garden. I am singing songs such as Mary Immaculate, Mother of God, and I was also singing Hosanna. And after I sang, I noticed it was blue earlier because of the absence of clouds. There were just few clouds from apart from each other, you know. But now it's just so amazing that. Really, indeed. I mean, I feel covered with the protection and love of the Lord because it's just cloud everywhere. I mean, all over my top, there's just so many clouds. It's just so enjoyable to see because when I realized the glory of God that He said in the Bible that when the Lord Jesus ascended, He was taken up to the heaven, a cloud before the apostles has came to in front of them, that the cloud has taken the Lord God to heaven. There is just the glory of God that is present in the clouds. So when I after I sang so many worship songs and also veneration to the Blessed Mother Mary, there's just so many clouds all over above me. And guess what? It's not raining, it's just clouds. I'm so happy. I was singing, Mary Immaculate, Mother of God, we sinners all know your sinless perfection, fallen and weep, for God's mercy we plead. Grant us the shield of your mighty protection. Measure your reign by the depth of our need. Bend from your throne of the voice of our crying. Look to this earth where your footsteps have trod. Stretch out your arms to us living and dying. Mary Immaculate, Mother of God. There you go. I really want to get closer to the Blessed Mother Mary. It is about venerating. The prayer and the singing to Blessed Mother is not worship, because worship is for the Lord. However, to the Mother Mary, it is called veneration. It is giving importance on how to honor her presence. And there you go. I just feel so good today. There was a butterfly flying hovering up in front of me. It was a very beautiful scene. It just flew in front of me and flew upwards. It's just so beautiful. Okay, so what do I have in my mind right now that I can vlog about? I think it's just a matter of okay, so what I have in my mind, I hope the Holy Spirit will bless me to put into my mind what it is that I have to speak about. But okay, so my realization is that the mercy of God that He has for people is when people are exemplifying His mercy. It is really deep that sometimes it's really hard to just become as forgiving as God is forgiving, because you know, no matter how vile the sins of people, when people come to Him, it is like similar to the joy of the celestial court that angels that celebrates in heaven are really expressing their great relief and joy and elation because of a repentant sinner. And everyone who would come to the Lord, the angels, the celestial court, are partying, celebrating. It's like in the Bible that it has been said like that. So when I would be thinking about the mercy, it's so deep that there is something that has to do with it is also in the book of Romans. I think I better be studying again because I need to really further study. But in the book of Romans, as far as I have read, that the righteousness of the Lord, Romans chapter 10 verse 8 to 13, that true righteousness of God indeed is when you believe that He has been crucified and God has risen Him from the dead. And with that, when you believe that in your heart, that is the true righteousness. So when I was thinking about mercy of God, really indeed, God's mercy is when His righteousness prevails. Because when people are sinners, everyone sins, of course, because nobody is perfect. But everyone is called for perfection because as the Heavenly Father is perfect, we are called to be perfect. And with that, God is so gentle with His Spirit that He can lead people to the level of spirituality that He is the one who is very present, ever present, because of His Holy Spirit. You know, as a person, as Romans 8 verse 11, that the Spirit of God who dwells in us, and also that in the Romans 8 that says that the Holy Spirit assures our spirit that we are child of God. It's really beautiful, you know. It is really beautiful to feel accepted in the kingdom of God. And with that in mind, it will just make you have the purpose to be driven in life to share the mercy and the righteousness of God. Because actually, it is really true that God wants salvation for all. And that the salvation indeed is practiced by people whom are moved by the Spirit of the Lord. Because what makes God just is not only when He faces us at the judgment day, but the just of the Lord is when people on earth are at work to show God as just because of the people being merciful. Just like in the Beatitudes that speaks about, blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. I think it is in the Matthew 5. I hope I'm not mistaken. I hope Matthew 5 or Matthew 10. I really need to review the Beatitudes. But however, I just realized that it's really difficult to just speak about mercy when it comes to the gravity of situation that takes place to other places that are in the dark, you know, the lack of light, because God is light. But there are places and situations in the world that lacks the presence of God because of the lack of the people showing just, being just. So it is the lack of showing God because of the lack of the people who show how to be just. That's why it's difficult when it is also in the Bible that says that there is such thing as judgment, or there are such things that are judgment without mercy because of the fear, because of not having, I'm sorry, I did a mistake. There is something in the Bible that says that there are such things as judgment without mercy because of the absence of fear of judgment. So I think that is so deep actually, but for me, how I understand it, I would like to just pray for it, because it would be enjoyable for the pleasure of people to experience when there is really the mercy of God that is being presented, that we feel from within us because of His Spirit being present in us, that makes us realize that we have to be on the move to treat people with love, because love and mercy itself is what God wills for us, as it is on earth as it is in heaven. God wills. Okay, God bless you guys. Thank you.